Alright guys, unfortunately we ran out of daylight, but basically I've got a million lights on this, so hopefully we can kind of do this and still be able to see. With the fronts, there's two options. There's an easy route and a hard route. I'm going the hard route. Basically the easy route is you would just throw it in here, route it to the footwell lights that sit up under the dash. Basically that. If you go that route on both sides, anytime a front door opens, they're gonna turn on, both, even if the door's closed. I don't want that. There probably wouldn't be too much light seep out, but I just, I'd rather do it right and have just one light when an individual door opens. To do that, we're basically gonna need a fish wire through the door and connect the wiring to the wiring for this door light. Those only turn on per side door. They're not linked to each other. So we're gonna have to start here with opening the door up, taking the whole door panel off, and I'm gonna show you how to do that here. All right, to remove the door panel, it's relatively easy. There's a screw in the defrost vent. We're gonna have to pop this cover out, and there's a screw behind it. There's a screw in this bushing here. There's also a screw up underneath the armrest, and then there are four across the bottom here. Gentle, you can just do it by hand. If you're worried you're gonna crack your door, you start hearing cracking, you may want to use a nylon pry tool. First, I'm gonna put it over here and disconnect this. Come off from here, you've got to raise the door up and it comes off. Kind of a pain. Make sure you have all your clips taken care of. Slide it back a little bit. Now, this part's pretty difficult. You've got to hold the door, you've got clips for the lock and window actuators and all of the good stuff. All right, finally got that off. You can see basically the cables connect there and there. Very simple how they attach. And then there's two clips. Pressing them in and pulling them out, it's pretty tough while you're holding the door frame. If you've got someone else to hold the door frame for you, that'd be a good route to go. If not, as you can see, it can be done by yourself, just takes a little more time. Next, we're gonna disconnect the speaker and take it out. It's got two clips. One to the rear of it, one on the top. Now, these are screws. You can take them out with a screwdriver. I'm personally gonna use an impact. Speed this up a little bit. Now, before getting them all off, I'm gonna disconnect this clip. I'm not sure if you can see, but it's basically a wiring clip that holds it to the speaker just to stabilize everything. Finally, there we go. All right, now that that's out of the way, I'll go ahead and
take off the last screw for this speaker.
Now the speaker just pries out. Doesn't take much. Alright. Set that aside for now. Alright, the next thing we're doing is, in all honesty, a pain in the ass. Basically, what we're going to do now is separate the carpet, and then we have to gain access to the box that transfers all the wires into the door, and then fished through our two wires that are going to connect to power. Carpet pulling up, simple. This comes up. There's a little stud that slips over at the front, so that's going to need pried out and around it. Not a big deal. Now, getting it around the parking brake, I just push it back a little bit. It comes out and around it. I just kind of, for now, I'm just going to lay it back. Actually, I may be able to hook it on my brake pedal to keep it held. There we go. That's actually convenient. All right. Now, there's a little box in here. Pretty similar to what we saw in the rear where the seat belts are. And I'm going to go ahead and you can't see, I may bring the camera in here, but basically all I'm doing is prying that box open so I can access the wires inside. There we go. It's actually easier to open than the rear door. I'm gonna go ahead and take the camera here. Here's the box. This passes through, goes from there to there, there, into the door, actually inside the door. What we're gonna have to do is, there's different ways to skin the cat. If you have a way that works better for you for feeding the wire through, go for it. What I'm going to do, and it's by no means the best method, it's the best method I know at least. I'm going to take mechanics wire, feed it through, because it's a little bit more rigid, easier to work through than a limp wire. Once I get it fed through, I'm going to twine it to a wire, or two wires in this case. And then I'm going to pull it back through to get the wire started. Alright, if you're not familiar with what mechanics wire is, it's basically just exactly that, metal wire. It's generally used for hanging brake calipers when you're working on it, or just anything you need to hang out the way. Like I said, it's just a little bit more rigid, obviously holds shape a little bit better than a wire by itself, so it's a little bit easier to feed through stuff. It doesn't just instantly run back on itself. So I'm just going to cut off a maybe a 3-foot section max, just enough that I can get through that doorway and have enough to hold on to on one end and wrap around a wire on the other. So this is probably going to take a while. I'm probably going to end up speeding this part up or potentially cropping it out. But basically the goal is I'm going to take the boot off here on the car side, not the door side. Going to feed it in from the door side up into the harness boot. Then I'm going to try to get it where I can find it on the basically the car boot side, if you will. And from there, it shouldn't be too hard to push down into the car. It's kind of a slow process. You just kind of got to work it little by little as you push it in there. So, just gotta have patience. Alright, I figured I'd take a second to show you kind of what I was talking about, the middle point. I've got it fed in the door, into the boot, from the door. It's coming through here. Now I've got it coming out of the boot that I took out of the car. That's kind of the middle ground. Now, on the inside, basically, I'm going to take, there's a
connector in there, so I'm gonna pull that back just a little bit to give us some room for this to come through. And now I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna have to obviously put the camera down. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this and start feeding it down into the door to get it back all the way into the cab. All right, now I've got it fed all the way through. As you can see, I still got enough to grab on the door side. I've also got a pretty fair amount coming out into the cabin. What I'm gonna do now is I've got two spools of wire. I'm doing it this way just so, since it's kind of a bitch to feed through, I'm doing it this way just so I know for a fact, I have no questions in my mind that I have more than enough wire through. So I'm not even gonna cut it. I'm gonna feed it through, still connected to the spool. So then once it's completely mounted on the door side, I can obviously cut it however I need for see fit for the cabin side where we're gonna be attaching it to the door sill. All right, so now I've got, like I said, folded over the wire there on itself so I can hold that while it's going through the boot. Up here, I've got it as a, trying to get the light on it. I've got it folded over as tight as possible, and then you can see the mechanics wire. I've got it twisted around itself pretty good so that doesn't come loose. Now, what we're gonna do here is, like I said, with one hand, I'm gonna stabilize the wire so it doesn't just basically pull them back through. With the other hand, I'm gonna start pulling on this. You've gotta finesse it a little bit. I do it in kind of halves like I did going in. I get them through the door and then kind of hand work them into the boot and then pull them through with the mechanics wire. There we go. Got the wires through. They're still connected to the spools on that side. Now what I'm gonna do, just because as I stated earlier, I really hate electrical work and I really don't wanna do this a second time. Just to not risk it, where I folded them over so sharply, I'm gonna cut these both off. I don't wanna use that section that's been pulled over so sharply. More than likely you'd be fine, but like I said, I'm just not willing to risk it. Wire's cheap, and like I said, I'd rather not pull it all apart again because I wanted to save 5 cents of wire. So now what I'm doing, pulling out a pretty good length on this end. A little wasteful with wire, but like I said, it's pretty cheap, so. All right. Basically, you've got to get enough wire here because it has to go down the door so it clears your window, obviously. The wire, actually, you can see the backsides of the clips here. You kind of follow it around these clips. It comes back up around. You've got a zip tie there. You have to take it all the way across. Got to get back enough. Take it all the way across to where this comes out, and I zip tie it to the back of that. Come down. There's a little triangle cut out here. I went through here and plan on doing it on this side as well. Then we're going to splice it in pretty close to the connector, just a couple inches back from it. And you got to leave these with enough play that they can obviously get around and you can position this on the door. But you also don't want too much that's going to slap around in there, be noisy, or potentially get into your window and create problems there. All right, I've got the wire fished through. I've also got it zip tied in many places. One thing I probably should have mentioned earlier, I zip tie it in as many spots as I can. You have to obviously keep in mind that the window comes down through here, so make sure not to get anything in its track or its way. Also, I try to fasten it as well as I can, mainly because I'm really anal, and if you leave it with a zip tie, you know, all the way at the front, then one all the way back here, it's probably not gonna have a problem, but you could have where you close your door and you just hear the wire, since they're loose, kind of ting against the door. I want everything to seem as factory as possible, so zip ties are cheap, so I just run them through there. try to keep it as close to the loom and, you know, as little that can swing around as possible. Now we're going to go ahead and connect it to the door lights. Basically, the light on the door sits pretty much in between these two screw holes here. So it ends up being probably, I believe, roughly right around here. With that being said, you still want to give it some room to move. You obviously don't want to end up connecting everything and then realizing that you can't even reach the socket. It's easy to slide a little bit more back up in there, just run it, you know, a little dog leg in it. So what we're going to do, first, I'm going to go ahead and clip off this connector. I'm going to take it off probably about an inch back from the connector to give us a little bit of room to work with. Sorry for the shadows here, I'm trying to keep everything lit. Then, to give us some more room to work here, I'm going to take the little sleeve that comes on these from the factory, and I'm just going to cut it up probably about 2 inches. A little short. Alright, now I'm going to fold that back over. Kind of get that out of the way. Unfortunately, Toyota left me with a sticky mess here, so this is being a little bit of a pain in the ass. Still got the wet rag around from earlier, so that's nice. All right. So now, since the connector goes in like this, I feel like it makes more sense to butt connector the actual door harness side and the wires here. So, like I said, I'm going to give it enough room that it could potentially reach almost all the way over here. So, looks like I'll cut them off about there. I'm going to take the wire strippers and be careful when you're doing this. This side of the harness is live, so don't touch the wires together. You know, don't cut them too close or let them run into each other. In fact, me saying that, I should probably listen to my own advice. I'm going to prep this side first, so I'm not leaving that side hanging while they're open. Might as well strip the connector side while we're at it as well. Actually, okay, there's that one. Actually, I'm changing it all up on us. Let's see here. I'm actually going to put the butt connectors on this each end of the connector first, being as that it's got no power and they're pretty close together. I feel like that makes a little bit more sense. So I'm going to go ahead and press that all the way in and crimp this joint. I should probably also mention, for this connection, I'm using the blue connectors versus the pink or red, whichever. On the chassis side, or the door side, I guess, the wires are a little bit thicker than what we ran into for the rear door installation. So it needed a little bit larger butt connector to be able to slide two wires in like we are. Alright, now that I've got this prepped, the little connector, as well as these prepped, I'm going to go ahead and do the now the live wires last. The bigger of the two wires, it's a red and yellow on both sides. That is actually the 12 volt
The other one's the ground. So I'm gonna go ahead and take off the ground first. If I can. There we go. Now take off the 12 volt. There we go. All right. Now, what I'm gonna do is let's see here. Make sure that I got these lined up. All right, so there's gonna be the red to red, or the red and yellow to red and yellow. Now, since I said the red and yellow, the larger wire is the 12 volts, I'm gonna keep 12 volt with red and the ground with black. You don't have to, just something I'm gonna do so I know for the future which is live and which isn't. Basically, I'm gonna go ahead and touch these together. I'm gonna twist them while trying not to shock myself touching the other one. Also, when you're getting in these butt connectors, I always try to make the ends of each wire as close to being equal as possible. All right. Now, with the clip itself, I'm gonna make sure that I'm pairing the red and yellow on the connector side to what's now the red, yellow, and red on the door harness side. And go ahead and crimp that so it's held. And same procedure as the rear doors. I always try to push the wires that I'm about to crimp into it as I'm getting ready to crimp it, and then go ahead and get a good crimp on there. This is much easier to crimp than working on the door jam like we were with the rear doors. Now, same procedure here. I'm gonna go ahead and twist these together. When I twist these together, the door light's probably gonna light up even before we crimp it to the connector. Or actually, don't even have that hooked up yet on that end, so we're good. Those twisted together, fed into the butt connector here. Getting them both in as deep as they can go. Now feed the crimpers through. Alright, get those pushed in there as good as possible. And go ahead and crimp that. There we go. Alright. Alright, now with the front doors, they're much easier to get lined up and equal on both sides than the rears are. Basically what I'm doing is clean this area just like we did the rear. Prep that. Now before we even get it wired in, I'm going to go ahead and stick it because then it holds it easier. I know where the wire lengths are, everything like that. Basically what I do, they've got a small divot you can see. Or I'm not sure if you can see in the video, a little bit of a raised section there. And what I do is I'm going to take these, sit them back all the way to the edge here. And I'm just going to get the corner of that up on that raise. Just like that. Same deal I'm doing with the, or same deal I did with the rear doors. I'm going to do with these. Just peel off a little bit of the 3M tape. Hang it out the side. And get that laid in there so I don't close that off. Now get this, I'm holding this just kind of up against the edge. And then like I said here with that, I'm gonna get it just on that lip. Just barely up on that raise. And with these held about there. Start sticking it. Make sure I kind of got it just square feeling across there. Get that started pretty good. I'll just pull this back while pressing it on there. Just as I'm going, I'm just kind of making sure I'm keeping this as level and held back to that incline there in the back. And there we go. Now the fronts are mounted.
Now with these, I find since I'm personally, you know, doing the heat shrink way, I'm gonna put them kind of, I ran the other ones, came down here, there's a little divot in the pinch weld there. I'm gonna fold it over there, bring it in just a little bit, and solder it back there. Now, what that does is it gives me a pretty good amount of wire here. I'm gonna cut these off long. So now these will be loose from the spool. I'm gonna cut them one at a time since they're live now. Okay, now with these, basically they're gonna have to be fished through the box and then take them down here, and they'll end up back down along the floor around here. Now before we get too far, I'm gonna take these, I'm gonna strip the ends and check them with the floor light or the sill light, make sure that it's working. We got these, just touch them together. And we have power. That's that. All right, now I've got these routed through a small hole in the side of the box here that we're working on. And now that those are through, I'm gonna kinda fish them down the side here. Just kinda following along the side of the body of the car. Get that on the inside there. Flip the light towards you. Alright, now before I let this short against the body, I'm going to take care of this hot first. Like I said earlier, I'm going to try to get it to sit right around here. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that off. Go ahead and cut this, snip that off there. That's taken care of. And now with this, I'm going to run it down a little bit like I said earlier. I'm going to cross over the pinch seam. I'm just kind of mocking up the approximate length I'm going to need. Let's see here. This goes back there. We'll say right about here. It's definitely, it goes without saying, it's a lot easier to cut them too long and have a little bit of wire that you just need to coil up or pack under something than coming up too short and having to butt connect or end wires or something along those lines. Now with this, I clipped that off. It's got a little sleeve around it, so I'm gonna go around a couple, about an inch and a half, 2 inch back. Go ahead and cut around that. Cut that sleeve off. There's that. Now the wires on these are connected. So now I'm carefully attempting to split these. Split started with some side cutters. Work better than the razor blade. I'll peel those back so I got some room to work with. Go ahead and strip both the ends of these to get them ready. That one back. Alright. Now with pink butt connectors on these, red. Do the smaller side first, get these started. Make sure I'm on the right one there. Keep it pressed in and smash it. Give it a little tug. Make sure that that's in there. Go on to the next wire.
That one smashed on there. Now I'm going to connect the ground here. Ground side first. Sometimes it's easier with the wires to give them a little twist. Keeps all the wires together, gets them a little bit easier to feed into the butt connector. Alright, get that fit in there. I stripped this one back a little bit far, so that's throwing me off. Alright, put that fit in there. Put that through. Alright, got a good crimp on that. Now, last but not least, the positive here. Hope that didn't fall on my door. That'd be one of those annoying jingles I was talking about earlier. Twist that. Oh, there they go, lighting up as they make connection. There we go, get it in there. Now we got a little more light. Alright, and then crush that one as well. Very nice, okay. Now, like I said, I think I did cut these a little bit long. Actually, they don't look that long. They look just about right, actually. So, that works out perfect. Now, next step we're going to go on to is obviously heat shrinking both of these. I'm going to do the one by the door first. These are pretty obviously much easier to heat shrink than the other side, a little bit further from things. Obviously, make sure you're not pointing at your door too much. Try to focus the heat on them. Also, trying to get a good hold of it where I can keep my hands back, not roast my hands, but also be able to aim them where I want them. Alright, with those done, it's time to do the ones on the chassis side. I'm just going to turn the tripod here. Alright, and now with the way I've done this, kind of a little bit of a strategy, I guess. I left these wires long. I also put the butt connector in the center. That makes this much easier to move away from the car, so you don't have to use the towel method. Obviously, that makes for a little bit safer too, I guess. So now I'm going to work on this with obviously watching, being mindful where I'm waving this. Not that I'm getting it up on my dash seat, or effectively the light as well. Alright, from here out, it's honestly pretty self-explanatory and simple. We have reinstalling everything on the door, the speaker, making sure all your clips are back on, putting your door and the cables for the door handle, all reinstalling that. I'm not really going to cover that. That's basically the just going in reverse of what it was to take it off. In addition to that, we got the carpet that just needs reinstalled. That's very simple, as well as the weather stripping, which is definitely self-explanatory. Obviously, this has been the driver's side of the car. All you got to do is repeat everything on this side, on the other side. I believe the wire colors are even the same on the front doors, as stated earlier in the video.
the rear door wires are different color from side to side, at least on mine. It may vary year to year, so go based off the pin location on the connector. That's gonna be it for the video. Thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions, feel free to comment. I'll try to keep an eye on that and try to be as helpful as I can be there as well. Overall, it's an awesome project. It's, as you can see, pretty in-depth, but I think with the right amount of patience, even if you're not too keen on electrical work, you should be able to figure it out, and definitely gives a pretty unique look and looks awesome once it's installed. I'll have some video after this of just the final product, I guess, opening it up, kind of showing the doors. Especially it's dark out, so it works out perfect. That's the end of it. Thank you.